evidence is showing that minimalist running shoes, particularly minimalist running shoes that feel the most barefoot-like, like the Vibram Five Fingers, the Saqqa X8, and the Free Your Feet, shoes that have a 2mm paper-thin or thinner outsole, may do a better job at helping you get off to a better start and improving your running form in ways that may lead to reduction in net forces, like reductions in peak impacts, which are bursts and high impacts, reductions in mechanical and compressive loading, as well as reductions in shear stress off the entire musculoskeletal system, particularly the knees and the lower back, as compared with trying to improve your running form in thickly cushioned conventional running shoes. In fact, a 2013 study in the journal Footwear Science, which is linked down below the video in the description box, the researchers found that runners who normally ran in conventional cushioned running shoes with a very thick underheel padding, who switched to running in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila, had far better outcomes in knee pain and back pain as compared with runners who went from running in conventionally thick cushioned running shoes to running in the Nike Pegasus 28 and the Nike Free. Most concerning is that the researchers found that the runners who ran in the Nike Free had a 192% increase in relative injury risk than the runners who ran in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila. This is because look at the Nike Frees, they are propped up on a thicker slab of firm cushioning that thickens and stiffens more at the heel as compared with the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila, which are essentially paper thin and fully flexible and completely flat. Whereas the Nike Frees overall have similar underfoot structural support as most traditional running shoes. And with that in mind, what's worse is that Nike markets the Nike Frees as actually having a minimalist shoe designed to specifically help facilitate the barefoot running style, which typically involves a forefoot strike landing and increased knee flexion or knee bend, both of which are on record for being low impact mechanics. However, when the runners ran in the Nike Free from their conventional cushioned running shoes, since the Nike Frees are marketed as a minimalist running shoe that's supposed to facilitate or encourage a non-heel strike landing and more barefoot-like stride mechanics like forefoot striking, greater knee flexion, or knee bend. At touchdown, the Nike Free runners actually retained their heel strike landing pattern as compared with the runners who went from running in their conventional thick cushion running shoes to running in barefoot-like running shoes like the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila. Most of the Vibram Bikila runners instantly avoided a heavy heel strike landing because they instantly adopted a forefoot strike with more pronounced knee flexion, a touchdown, whereby these two mechanical outputs, which are forefoot striking and greater knee bend at touchdown, are proven highly effective in really unburdening the knees and the lower back, which is no surprise that the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila runners had a 192% reduction in heavy loads off the knees and the lower back, because the heightened ground feel provided by the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila's paper-thin outsole most likely helped maximize the runner's mechanical and reflexive effectiveness in avoiding high-impact landings in the absence of thick underfoot cushioning, and avoidance of high impacts when running in large measure comes from making initial ground contact on the balls of the foot just ahead of the arch, or in other words, the forefoot, while keeping both knees softly bent and therefore flexed at all time, but especially at touchdown. These two mechanical outputs really seem to come about and be optimized when you can feel the ground more fully with your feet. As for the Nike Free runners, the hard truth is the Nike Frees provide zero ground feedback. You cannot feel the ground at all with your feet in the Nike Frees like you can in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila. And the Nike Frees actually have a very similar structural framework as most conventional running shoes. So really, there's no good reason to classify the Nike Frees as a minimalist running shoe or a barefoot-like running shoe, even though they are marketed as being more minimalistic. However, the Nike Frees are not fully functional in a barefoot way like a true minimalist running shoe. The Nike Free's outsole is quite thick, hence no ground feel. The underfoot nerves don't get stimulated to levels like they do in a much thinner sole shoe. And because of the lack of ground feel and thus low stimulation, sensation and activation on the underfoot sensory nerves. In the Nike Freeze, you're not going to get that most maximum level of foot strike correction or accuracy like you would get in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila, and you might not get a functional level of impact protective knee joint flexion responses and enhanced knee joint mechanics when you are learning to develop good low impact running form if you're running in the Nike Freeze as compared to running in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila. And that's something that I really can't stress enough, is that when you have strong underfoot sensory feedback like you get when you run barefoot, or if you run in a very thin barefoot-like running shoe under these heightened sensory input conditions, the increases in underfoot ground feel directly prompts the knees to reflexively and automatically slightly bend and softly flex at touchdown. And it's this slight knee bend at touchdown that's going to help give you more powerful, more functional stride control, in that when you bend your knee at touchdown when you run, doing so automatically pulls the landing foot to land closer to your torso, which is the center of mass. And when your foot lands closer to your center of mass when you run, the brake force duration period is significantly reduced. And from this, the compressive loads on the knee and the back are greatly reduced as well. Also, bending your knee at touchdown when you run adds more spring and responsiveness to your stride, simply because it makes the elastic structures of the lower leg, namely the arch in the feet and the Achilles tendon, more spring loaded. It helps the foot spring up off the ground more responsively and effortlessly, and also helps improve shock absorption at each step. So these mechanics, which are increased knee flexion or knee bend at touchdown, and forefoot striking, which are brought about more fully when you run barefoot or run in barefoot-like running shoes, based on the study's results, which are results that are directly in line with results from many other similar studies, learning to correct your hard-hitting heavy heel strike landing to a forefoot strike landing when either running barefoot or in running in barefoot-like running shoes may do a better job at leading to more immediate improvements in helping you develop more functional, less force-intensive foot strikes and leg swing mechanics that get better with time the more you run barefoot or in barefoot-like running shoes, and the more you integrate barefoot running into your overall training regimen may really do more to speed the process in helping get those mechanical corrections more hardwired into your neuromuscular system and your reflexive memory, so that you can uphold those very same functional low impact mechanics that sustains much better on your knees long term for when you do actually run in shoes, as compared with trying to make those form improvements at the foot strike and knee joint mechanical level in thickly cushioned running shoes. Also, knowing all this remains a case in point, as the researchers found that the runners who ran in the Nike Free from their traditional running shoes had a significant uptick in relative injury risk than the runners in the Vibram Five Fingers Bikila, on the basis of the Nike Free runners retained their heel strike landing pattern, and they also retained greater knee extension or lack of knee flexion at touchdown, which drove up the amounts of loading on the knees and the lower back. The Nike Freeze does have much less underheel padding than most traditional running shoes, but the Nike Freeze still are quite padded at the heel, and like in traditional running shoes, the underheel padding in the Nike Freeze still props up the foot on such an angle that actually helps facilitate a heel strike landing pattern during running, which generates a measurably heavy impact peak. The most concerning part is the feel of this impact spike. A heel strike is masked by the underfoot cushioning, so the underheel padding takes the sting off the heel at heel strike when really the impact peak is produced. However, the underheel padding does nothing to dampen or reduce this impact peak at heel strike, so this impact peak ends up piercing through the heel up the lower leg and slams into the lower back. Also at heel strike, especially when the knee of the landing foot is completely unbent and stiff, not bent or softly flexed, is going to cause an elongated overstride, which produces a longer brake force period, which sends additional loading, especially compressive loading across the shins, knees, and the lower back. So the bottom line here is that there's not enough underfoot padding in the Nike Freeze to dampen the heavy impact peak or reduce the break force duration period that are consequentially always generated at heel strike during running. And those two force variables, an impact peak at touchdown and a long break force duration period, produced more so in heel strike running than in forefoot strike running, have a lot of scientific backing for putting a heavy load on the knees, resulting in runner's knee. These stressors also put additional loading across the long bones, making a femur fracture quite possible. This is why femur fracture risk is much more prevalent in heel strike runners, not so much in forefoot strike runners. These two force variables also permeate as a shockwave that ripples up the leg and it crashes into the lower back, causing throbbing lower back pain. I must really underscore that the impact peak at touchdown is not generated in a forefoot strike landing during running, and the break force duration period is significantly reduced, which is why the Bikili runners had such stark reductions in knee and lower back pain. The Vibram Five Fingers Bikila runners instantly adopted a forefoot strike landing because running in these shoes with absolutely no underheel cushioning delivers very strong sensory cues that encourage you to avoid landing heel first and instead land with a forefoot strike, which again is a low impact foot strike as compared with heel strike running. Equally important, the heightened underfoot ground feel that you get from running in barefoot leg running shoes, these increases in ground feedback at the underfoot directly puts into motion impact avoidance reflexes that drive faster, more accurate responses in adjusting your foot strike intensity and for a safer position footfall, meaning that you land with less downward force and push forces and generate less of a collision force with the foot. So overall, you are striking the ground much less forcibly because you are typically going to land with a forefoot strike in the absence of under heel cushioning. And also, you're going to have more functional stride control because increases in ground feel at the underfoot when you run actually tells your knees to slightly bend and flex at touchdown, of which this increased knee bend or knee flexion during running under barefoot leg conditions will give you better stride control, and it helps guide your initial foot strike placement to land closer to your center of mass or your upper body, of which this positional arrangement seems to be very critical for reducing the break force duration period, which is really going to significantly help reduce compressive loads off the foot and the leg, but especially off the knee. So this study, along with other studies like it, have really found the same basic conclusion in that the sensory approach can really lead to measurable improvements in making more functional corrections to your running form, corrections that sustains well long term. Running form tends to improve whenever you can really feel the ground more fully. The strong higher level sensory input under the foot that you get when you run barefoot or in barefoot like running shoes may play more of a leading role in helping those who are really struggling to be able to put their forefoot running mechanics on a strong functional footing, compared with developing functional, sustainable, less force-intensive running form in thickly cushioned running shoes. That's not to say that you should never wear thickly cushioned running shoes. Elite runners wear them, but elite runners also do a lot of barefoot strides as well, especially elite runners, elite distance runners from East Africa. Barefoot running strides are a big part of their training. That's a fact, and that's because it fits so nicely into the role of injury prevention in that it keeps the feet and ankles functionally strong and tolerant of longer and harder miles. It keeps your balance unshakable. You're going to have unshakable balance if you are going to be running in thickly cushioned running shoes like the Nike Vaporfly, for example. The biggest takeaway is that when it comes to making it easier for you to improve your forefoot running form in ways that sustains better on your knees and the rest of your body, there definitely seems to be a strong sensory component that goes into helping you do that. And the results from the study also suggest that protection from harmful impacts when running comes from not always with increased underfoot cushioning, but with adjusting your foot strike to initially strike farther away from the heel, landing closer to ahead of the arch. And again, one of the best paths that can offer a faster way for you to learn how to efficiently use your foot strike and leg swing mechanics when running is with more sensory assisted feedback at the feet via barefoot running or running in very thin barefoot leg running shoes. This will help you develop natural impact adaptations in part by magnifying your perceptual awareness of your foot strike's positioning, posture, and intensity. And best of all, you are strengthening the feet along the way. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already, where you'll stay more informed on the benefits of barefoot running as well as minimalist running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.